Hello guys, I am Engineer Muhammad Adnan Khan and you are watching YouTube channel Being Engineer. Please subscribe my YouTube channel to get new uploads. Today we learn about the calculation of material required for a slab. As we know, concrete is a mixture of three ingredients, mainly cement, sand and crush. When these materials are mixed in a fixed proportion, they form concrete. Ratio of material to be used here is 1:2:4. 1 is for cement, 2 is for sand, 4 is for crush or coarse aggregate. Now let's assume the dimensions of a slab. Its length is 30 feet, its thickness is 0.5 feet or 6 inches and width is 20 feet. To get the volume of total volume of a slab, we will multiply all these three dimensions. We will get 300 cubic feet. Now this is the wet volume of a concrete. Now to get the dry volume of a concrete, we will multiply it with a dry constant which is 1.54 multiplied by this volume, we will get 462 cubic foot, which is the dry quantity of a material required for a slab. Next step is sum of ratio. The ratio we are using is 1:4. Sum up 1 + 2 + 4 = 7. Now to get the quantity of materials, we will use the formula: ratio of ingredient multiplied by total dry volume divided by sum of ratio. For calculation of cement, we will use 1 multiplied by 462. 1 is for cement in this ratio, multiplied by 462 is the total dry volume, and sum of ratio is 7. We will get 66 cubic foot. So this amount of this quantity of cement will be required for casting of a slab. Now to get the number of bags, we will divide this volume divided by 1.25, as volume of a cement bag is 1.2 cubic feet. We will get number of bags, which comes out to be 52.8 bags. So for calculation of sand, we will use 2 multiply by 462. 2 is for sand, multiply by 462 is the total dry volume, divided by sum of the ratio, which is 7. We will get 132 cubic feet. Similarly, for calculation of crush or coarse aggregate, we will use 4 is for crush, multiply by 462, which is total dry volume, divided by sum of the ratio, which is 7. We will get 264 cubic feet.